I look like a fucking YouTuber. I can't even vibe yet. You don't realize how long I've been wanting to do YouTube, and I didn't feel like I had the right look or had the right energy. I didn't know if I was good enough, but right now, look at this setup, look at this room, look at my face. I've just built this, by the way. I thought, look, if I build this, it's amazing. It's a good backdrop. Come on, I have to shoot a video. And looking at it now, what? Let me turn on this light, see if it's better. I don't even think that worked. Anyways, I think I'm going to, well, I am going. I don't know when though. I haven't booked anything, and it's in about 20 days Thailand trip to get my teeth done. They look white on camera. I'm not saying I don't have bad teeth. They're great teeth. But they're not perfect. And I've always been a little bit insecure about that because these front two teeth are actually half fake. When I was in primary school, me and my friend were talking a little bit too much in class, and we got kicked out, and I was looking over the windowsill, and I was resting my teeth on the wood bit, and he pushed my head, chipped both my teeth, and I'm like, didn't really hurt, but I could feel it really sensitive, and it was cold when I took a breath in. But his face, he was like, oh, what happened? Is it bad? Like, I couldn't feel anything. And then we went to the bathroom, and I'm thinking, like, these are my real teeth. These are my adult teeth. What happens if the dentist can't fix it? And that got me thinking, like, stressing. I didn't cry, but he started crying. And I'm like, what are you crying for? You freaking did this to me. But anyways, these are actually fake. And I chipped this one again. That's why this one's a bit longer than this one. But whatever. I've had braces. I've had fillings or whatever they're called in these two teeth twice now probably. But honestly, I think when I get this done, like when I did this straight away, it's like, wow, should have done that 3 years ago, and then I could have had it on the ball rolling already. So next time you see me, I will be on my way to Thailand, maybe have a new smile, and we'll see what other things we can get up to while we're there. So I will talk to you later. Make sure you like, subscribe, and join the family. I don't have a girlfriend, but I know it's coming as well. My favorite word in this world is foreshadowing. I'm gonna get it tattooed. I was thinking about getting, I don't know, we'll see. I might get it tattooed here, foreshadowing, because everything you put your mind to, you can actually do it. Like, I tell people and I tell myself, literally, like, if you want this more than anything in the world, but don't focus solely on that, say money, right? If you want money, you can work, you can do whatever you have to do to make money, but you're not focusing on, how do I get $20 in my hand right now? You have to look through that, almost believe that you already have it, and then you'll do things, you'll act a certain way, you'll make certain decisions based on that. And then you'll get what you wanted in the end. It might not happen in a week, it might not happen in months, but it will come eventually if you keep at it. So that's what I believe is foreshadowing. That's really what I live my life by, and maybe you'll see it on the side of my head one day. Maybe. made it to Thailand. That was the Monday. The next day, on Tuesday, when she said, come, we'll start the process, I woke up to this Snapchat. Ooh. If you know about Veneers, hit me up. Exactly 1 year ago. Which, to be honest, I find that crazy. Like, what I was saying before about foreshadowing, I've probably wanted Veneers for about 3 years now. And then I was serious about putting it out there, letting people know, okay, I want Veneers. Who has done it? Who has somebody that they can show me, okay, this is what Veneers look like in person? I said that a year ago, and a few people hit me up like, oh, it's too expensive, it's you're gonna ruin your teeth. My parents kind of said, you know, your teeth are perfect, your teeth are fine, why are you going to ruin them? It was almost like I knew they were going to be like this eventually. I've wanted it for a long time, so, you know, now it's happened, which is crazy to me, especially a year later since I sent that Snapchat. And I'll show some before and after photos. You can see this one was chipped and this one was a bit longer, and then on the bottom, for some reason, this one was a bit longer up and this one kind of leant to the side and was down a bit, maybe to compensate the bite where it was like that. I actually have these models of before and after teeth, which the dentist laughed at me when I wanted this. I think she thought I was a bit weird. So you can see that's my top teeth. This one was chipped and this one was a bit longer. And then the bottom, you have this one that's a bit lower and this one that's a bit higher. So that was my original teeth. She took a mold on the first day, and when I went back on the second day, she showed me this, which is a wax model of what my teeth would be. Now, something that I really didn't like about my teeth was here, there was a massive gap in the side between the canine and this first front tooth, I guess, which overall I didn't like. When I smiled, you could see massive gaps, but this, I was like, damn, that looks damn near perfect. And you can see the red lines where the gum had to be reshaped a little bit. And also here, there's a little red line where the tooth had to be shaved down, especially on this canine here, had to be shaved down a lot because my old tooth would come up and fill that gap on the side. But seeing that, already I was keen. I wasn't nervous, I was keen to have this great smile. Second appointment. I go there and she starts the injections. She puts them up the top first and then makes her way down to the bottom, and this is for grinding the teeth down. I don't know why, but in that moment, I was thinking, okay, I've made a mistake. I'm not sure if I want to go through this. You know, my heart was racing, like, I'm starting to sweat on my upper lip, and I'm thinking, I have just ruined my life. But luckily, she started grinding down the top right first. Didn't hurt a bit. I could just, you know, smell a bit of like grinding smoke, see the dust come up, but it didn't hurt. And I was like, okay, that's fine. The teeth look good in that model, so they're gonna look good on me. It was just that unknown, that risk that you had to take to get there, that was a bit nerve-wracking for me. You can see what they look like when she grounded them down. And again, I was nervous when I saw that because, you know, you don't know if they're going to be, you don't know what the final product looks like. And if you're left with those teeth, she said it's irreversible. So basically you just have to hope that they do a good job, which they did, and I'm really happy. So after all that was done, she put the temporary veneers on. Alright, so today my teeth got grinded down for about 2 hours, and they put injections everywhere, top and bottom. These are the temporary veneers while the porcelain veneers get made. They're a lot bigger than my old teeth, and they're not the same color that I'm going to get when it's finished. It will be whiter when I finish, but I think they're pretty good already. They are bigger, and it's going to take a bit to get used to, but you get used to it, and it's a lot better than what I had. I got OM3, which is the third whitest you can go, because the natural white, I think it was called B1, I'm not 100% sure though, it didn't really look, any different to my original teeth, which I found pretty crazy, because when you look at the before and after, they are quite yellow. So this OM3 was brighter than the naturalist white you can get, but it wasn't crazy white where if you go to a bowling alley and you smile, your teeth are going to light up like fluorescent. So from that second appointment with the temporary veneers on now, there wasn't much pain at all. They did give me ibuprofen, 300-400 milligrams, and then it was fine. There wasn't really much more pain. I went to a island tour, Banana Island, which was great. That was good fun. But then the other days in Thailand, I just stayed at the beach. We got a moped, riding around. It was all good. And a week later, I went back to Sea Smile Dental Clinic in Patong and got the temporary veneers taken off. They had to do injections again. They did a deep clean of the gums and the teeth that were grinded down. And then they started putting on these porcelain veneers.
Are you a YouTuber?
My a little bit.
Let me help.
Special retractor now.
Feeling good.
Good.
Is it okay?
Proper dental hygiene, proper care for your mouth, for your skin, for your body. I definitely think it's worth it. So when she was putting on those porcelain veneers one by one, it was another 3 hours worth of work. My Jesus Christ. But anyways, it was all good in the end, and I'm very, very happy with the teeth. I would definitely recommend them, because it's a Mallow clinic too. So I think it's a Swedish company, but they have clinics all over the world. So you can go to this clinic, to that clinic, and still get the same service, because they're all trained by the same company. It's just crazy because, okay, I'll get into price. It's not to flex, but pricing here in Australia is about $25,000 for 20 teeth, this set. I got 18, so maybe it goes down, you know, $22,000 or something. It's about probably $1,200 to $1,700 per tooth in Australia. In Thailand, it was about $500. But then I negotiated a discount, and it was a little bit less than that. And then when I was there, I checked on their website again, and they had a promotional price maybe for Christmas, and it went down again, which was a massive bonus because that was a few thousand dollars right there, and it all adds up. I went over there expecting to spend $10,000 on these teeth. I think I got away with it for about $8,000 or $8,500, with the cleaning, with the taking off my metal retainer from the back of my teeth, top and bottom, with the retainer that I have to wear at night now, and also the home bleach kit for the last two or three teeth on each side of the bottom. And to be honest, I think that's pretty good. But in saying that, I'm trying to get this YouTube money, I'm trying to get brand deals, and I'm trying to get AdSense money, even though it's gone down the drain now. So money is very important, and I will always keep money as one of my top priorities. But in 2020, I think my focus should be on people, on relationships, on building real relationships. So I hope you all had a Merry Christmas. I hope you all have a Happy New Year's, Happy Holidays, stay safe. If you want to know any questions about my teeth or about the process, Instagram is @BrendanOwen_. You've got this YouTube video in the comments as well, because I would have watched 300 videos on veneers before I decided to get them. So if you want to get them done, I hope this helped. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll see you soon. All these niggas can't compare me, don't you put me on no list, yeah. Turned her to Shakira, this white girl moving her hips. The mouth that used to curve me coming hearts under my pixie.